Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my dear brothers and sisters and viewers of Iqra TV. Welcome back to another edition of Real Talk. I'm your host Iqbal Bana. I hope all of you have had a very pleasant and spiritually uplifting Ramadan. It has been a very tough month in a number of ways. Many of us, all of us around the world, have been suffering under this COVID-19 coronavirus which has been going around the world. This Ramadan has been completely different. You know, we've not been able to go to the masjids, for example, those who go to the masjids. We've not been able to see our families, our friends throughout the whole of the month. We've been isolated, and tragically, many of us have lost family members or friends during this pandemic that is, as I said, affected the whole of the world. And in that pandemic, we've seen some really amazing work that has been going on, both in terms of how people have supported each other and helped each other throughout this very, very, very difficult and challenging times that we've all witnessed. And today I want to talk to you about some of the work, the amazing work that has been happening, not just in our communities, but the whole community that surrounds us wherever we may live. But in particular, I want to talk about one aspect, and that is the aspect of people where we've lost members of our family or friends within that we've known over these, particularly in the month of Ramadan. As I say, the restrictions on the number of people who could go and visit the relatives in hospital, which is virtually nil. People who could be in hospital with their family, with their loved ones, which most of the time they died alone. And people who could actually be in the funeral itself, attend the funeral services, and even give ghusl. All these were extremely restricted. And all of this played havoc with members of the family, whoever they may be. And that is something that has been a tragedy that many, as I say, many families have suffered. And in that tragedy, there's some real heroes who emerge, particularly when it comes to people who've lost members of the family and friends as well. And I want to talk about two of those people who are with me today. And they are, you know, from one of the local communities here, and that is the Sadqa-e Jariya Funeral Services, which is based in Dewsbury area. And they have been doing some fantastic work helping families through this very traumatic time, extremely challenging times as well. Because most of the people who passed away have actually been victims of the coronavirus, and therefore they've been in hospital. They've not had any visitors because of the restrictions. And then these brothers have had to pick up the pieces, helping the family navigate through the whole process of collecting the bodies, giving ghusl, and giving them the janazah rites as well. So my guests today are Muhammad Javed and Kamran Ahmed. Muhammad Javed, Kamran, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Real Talk. Thank you for being here today. It must have been a really, really difficult and challenging times. It must have been for those who've lost their family members, but it must have been for you as well. So can you say, how have you coped with it?
Yeah, sure. I mean, walaikum salam wa rahmatullah, and thank you for inviting us onto Iqra channel. It has been an extremely difficult period. It's been extremely difficult for families. Mm-hmm. It's been difficult for us because obviously we're a volunteer.
You provide this service absolutely free.
Absolutely free.
And totally you've got 50 volunteers.
Alhamdulillah, we have 50 volunteers. We have 6 vehicles. We're predominantly based in Kirklees, but we cover wherever required. So we have held pressure points. When we've helped in London. We've helped in other areas. So wherever our services is required, mm-hmm. we have up to 6 special teams. And the way we help is to take the way the pressure from the family, when I say pressure, when somebody loses a loved one, especially during COVID period, mm-hmm. when the death rate is high, mm-hmm. what we want to do is be able to allow the family to grieve. And when we say allow the family to grieve, because we've lost our own parents in the last 2 years, we were totally lost. Mm-hmm. You know, who do we turn to? Who do we ask? Where do we go? How do we register? All this. And Sadqa-e Jariya is all about one-stop solution. Right. So there's one point of contact that deals with everything. Mm. The only time we want the family or need the family is either for a registration or officially.
This is the registration of the death itself.
Registration of the death itself.
Right. Yeah.
So yes, it has been extremely difficult period. The last few months, the death rate has obviously expedited in the sense that the more and more people have died. It's been difficult because obviously, you know, we're blessed. And I want to say we're blessed. Locally, we're blessed because there are a lot of good organizations that help and pick up bodies very quickly, more or less straight away. There are other parts of the countries where people are taking anything up to 48 hours to pick up a body and then a further 48 hours. So the way Sadqa-e Jariya, or the philosophy of Sadqa-e Jariya, is to help grieving families to help them in their time of need.
I mean most families will not, if somebody suddenly dies in their family, they don't have a clue of what to do and how to navigate through the procedures and the processes.
Absolutely.
So how do they contact you?
We've got a 24/7 hour contact. We've got three numbers that we're advertising. We've got one number which is...
So if somebody dies in my family, I can contact you and then you take over all of the procedures and the processes.
If somebody dies within your family, you ring one of the three numbers, 24/7, available all the time. Mm. We will immediately react in terms of providing you. Doesn't matter what time it is, early hours of the morning, whatever. Even if people just need us to be there to help and support and guide them, we will. This isn't about we're not coming out, because all about Sadaqah. For us, Sadaqah Jariyah is the priority.
Right.
Yes, I do have other businesses, but everything stops because this is our prime commitment, that Sadaqah Jariyah, to help families. So if you have a bereavement, you just contact us. We will look after everything. We will guide you.
Mm.
You have the choice, as in what you want to do, and we will sort of abide by that, but we will guide you in the right directions and we will help you Islamically.
So you provide
everything.
Emotional counselling support.
Emotional counselling support, coroners, even to the extent of repatriation, the whole thing, you know, in dealing with registrars, dealing with hospitals, you know, you right across the board. Mm. And we've experienced...
One of the things, obviously, the government brought in as part of the sort of preventing of the COVID, the expansion of COVID, was to limit the number of people who could be involved in ghusls. And obviously, you had to have trained people in there.
Yep.
Now, did you organize the training yourself? And you, the 50 volunteers were trained up by yourselves?
Absolutely. I mean, firstly, I'd like to say we're regulated by NAFD, which is National Association of Funeral Directors.
Mm-hmm.
We're one of the first ones, one of the probably only ones at this moment in time in the North and in Scotland that's NFD regulated. So we're regulated by that, but at the same time, we've trained every member of our team to be able to be flexible, to do ghusls, to pick up bodies, because there is a lot of precautions that need to be taken in order for that to happen. And we do not want to risk families being part of something that we can't provide the protection. So we guide, protect, and provide PPE equipment, you know, guidance, for ghusl, for transportation. We send our own teams out to the mortuaries, to the hospitals, to the homes. So all these volunteers, none of them are being paid, but because of Sadaqah, they are prepared to pick up their bodies. And yes, all our staff are totally trained. And at the same time,
but we share family members who are not trained, who are not allowed to participate in ghusls, are they?
No, people that are not trained aren't allowed to participate in ghusls. If the family is COVID, obviously there is a restriction. That family has to be isolated.
Mm-hmm.
So if the family has to be isolated, then they can't be part of the ghusl. But where obviously there are other family members that are not part of that family, the immediate family, mm-hmm. they can be part of that ghusl. We will train them before we allow them to do ghusls. Right. Ghusls is restricted between 4 and 6 people at this moment in time.
Yes.
So, you know, it isn't the norm. But and again, you know, we've worked very closely with the community and the mosques and places. We've selected certain mosques for actual ghusls, for COVID ghusls. So not every mosque is doing COVID. So there are selected areas where we know that we can sort of sanitize, deal with that particular mosque.
They have the appropriate facilities. Yeah. So Kamran, I mean, obviously you're a young man.
Yep.
Right, mashallah, may Allah give you strength. I mean, young people engaged in this activity, obviously is something that we as a Muslim community should be proud of. So in these 50 volunteers that you've got, you know, what's the proportion of young people engaged in this work?
Well, I'm one of the volunteers.
Right.
And there are like 20, 30 youngsters.
MashaAllah.
So, you know, we try getting youngsters on board because we are the next generation.
Definitely.
And we need to know, you know, the procedures around death and what a person should do.
I mean, to be honest with you, it's a very taboo subject. Not a lot of people talk about death.
A lot of people are afraid, aren't they?
Absolutely. Yeah, you know, and alhamdulillah, one of the things that we encourage in Sadaqah Jariyah, and I said this before numerous times, is Sadaqah Jariyah belongs to 3.2 billion Muslims. The name is synonymous. Sadaqah Jariyah doesn't belong to any of us. So every single part in terms of Sadaqah Jariyah, is, you know, everybody's part of it.
Mm.
Youngsters we encourage more for the simple reason is they're the future. I'm not shameful to say I'm 50. You know, and obviously, who knows?
Still a young man.
But still a young man, but still an old person, as far as I'm concerned. But the youngsters, alhamdulillah, we've had so many youngsters come on board. And it makes me proud that the fact that more and more youngsters are taking that interest in
being able to deal with that. Actually, I think one of the things I have learned during this very difficult and challenging times, I mean, I know in my community when somebody passes away, not only the very close family but friends will also want to be there to give the ghusl. And, you know, this is something I've seen that is an important part of the rites of passage, you know, for the person who's passed away and for the family. But I have noticed that particularly at this time when there was restrictions placed by the government, that there are a lot of young people have come forward and volunteered to be trained so they can give the ghusl in the appropriate way. And I witnessed this, you know, in other parts of the country.
Right.
As well. So yeah, it is right, Kamran. There has been a young, and this, I think this is the really strength of Islam. And it's nice to see that our young people, we've not lost a generation. You know, we say that there's a lost generation out there. We do have some, mashallah, very, very good, strong, Islamically minded young people who believe that, you know, their responsibility is not just to themselves, but to the community. I mean, how did you start off with this Sadqa-e Jariya, you know, fi-sabilillah service that you've got, funeral service of yours?
Sadqa-e Jariya started, there's a story behind it, but obviously there isn't time to be able to discuss it. But in short layman's term, we had a bad experience ourselves. So our father passed away. It was one Sunday, early hours of the morning. I clearly remember it. We hadn't a clue what to do ourselves. So we made a call to a funeral director, and the only question that we were asked at the time is, are you doing a repatriation? Are you taking the body abroad? And we said no. And the answer we got was slightly shocking for us. It was, well, if that's not the case, then I'm afraid it's not worth my while coming out to you. Well, and that's the first time we woke up to the fact, doesn't matter.
Was this a non-Muslim funeral director?
No, there was a Muslim funeral director, unfortunately. But you know, that's when we woke up to the fact that, you know, here we are, doesn't matter how much education, you know, how much money, whatever, we ain't got a clue. We haven't a clue what to do. So that was our first bad experience. And then the following day, we went from pillar to post in trying to find out what the process is, how we go about it, who to contact, because it had been a Sunday, et cetera, et cetera. Alhamdulillah, Allah Ta'ala helped and it all came together. But one thing it gave a shock to the system for us to say, look, if you're educated and alhamdulillah, you know, you're well off, you still haven't got a clue what to do here.
And well, most people are ignorant about the process and the procedures, aren't they? You know, and that most people rely on others who have experience and knowledge in this field to help them navigate through the process. So I agree with you. But, you know, obviously, so that's the start of your journey.
That was the start of the journey. So we made our mind up that going forward, that we were going to support our community. Because for 30 years, I'd spent most of my time either abroad or down south with corporate blue chip companies. And when my father was ill, I decided to come back home and regardless and said, that's it. I'm calling it a day. So alhamdulillah, Allah Ta'ala gave me a year to spend with my father. And it gave me the opportunity to learn and find what is the right way, what the process is. So that's where it was born. And similar thing happened to the other trustees. So Nasir Jan.
So we've everybody has suffered some tragedy.
Yeah, absolutely.
In their life, right. So, I mean, obviously it started from a tragedy and something really important and very good has come out of this. I mean, as far as, you know, I see it, this is something that is, we should be proud of, applaud the work that you're doing. But when we come back, we need to go back for a break now with us. So inshallah, we'll come back to in the next section. We'll talk about the type of help and how many people in this particular COVID time that you have helped, you know, with the families with. So don't go away. Have a tea, coffee. Inshallah, we'll be back very soon. Take care. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.